Hello, I'm Graham and I do hope everyone's having a great day and welcome to today's video in which I'm having a look at the AF macro mode and the macro zoom mode that's now employed on the FZ300, 330 and indeed on the FZ1000 and the 2000 cameras. Now the macro zoom mode doesn't appear on the FZ200 but AF macro does. So some of the features that I'll be talking about with AF macro will apply to FZ200 users as well. Now, first of all, what is the AF macro mode? What does it give you over the standard AF mode? Well, with the standard AF mode, the camera will only focus down to about 30 centimeters or about 12 inches. So in its standard mode, I'll just check that I'm on the AF mode. If I'm trying to take a subject like this camera here, the FZ1000, and I wanted to take a close-up view to give me the image size that I need, if I try to take this picture, the camera won't focus and it gives me that non-focus indication. So I've got to move the camera back to get me that focus point, but then my image size starts to decrease. To get back to the image size that I want, I can now use the AF macro mode. So by depressing the side button, it allows me to select between AF and AF macro mode. And I can use a side wheel or I can use the back navigation dial to select AF macro. Press menu set to lock that in place. I can now move the camera within 1 centimeter of the subject. That does give me some problems in terms of lighting. And if I'm shooting natural history subjects like insects, they may not allow me to get that close to take that picture anyway. So first of all, considering the lighting, even with ring flashes or LED ring units, you can't get sufficient light at the angle you need at 1 centimeter. So it precludes you from using the very close distances unless you're in sunlight and you've got lights shining down onto your subject where you can illuminate it properly. So using the very, very close AF macro modes probably isn't going to be a solution for most people. There are alternatives we can use, and that is in the AF macro mode or in the AF mode, using longer focal length lenses, so using a longer zoom times 4, 5 or up to times 24 to give that long telephoto lens. But then we'll use a close-up lens to reduce the working distance. Now it can be a simple single element lens, it can be an achromat lens, or you can use the multiple compound lenses like the Raynox to allow you to get closer to your subject at longer focal lengths. Now the way this adapter lens system works is as follows. If I have the camera set to a particular focal length, and in this case I've got the FZ300 set to 600mm effective focal length or times 24. I've got the camera set to manual focus and I've set it to the infinity mark. Now if I put the number one close-up lens in front of the camera lens, the camera will focus an image at 1 meter away. So I've reduced infinity down to 1 meter. Now, if I change my focus point to something less than infinity, when I use the number one close-up lens, then that distance from 1 meter will be progressively smaller as well. If I was to apply the number two lens, the infinity focus will change down to 50 centimeters. And if I put the number four close-up lens, the closest focus distance will change down to 250 millimeters or 25 centimeters. So the strength of the lens will allow you to get closer to your subject and hence give you a bigger image size and hence the image magnification that you require. That applies to the FZ200 in the AF mode or in the FZ1000 in the AF mode or AF macro mode. So you can use the adapters to get closer to your subject to give you that larger image size. There's no loss of aperture, no loss of light by using these close-up lenses. So you can use them without having to use an extended shutter speed or higher ISOs. With the cheaper lenses, the single element lens, you may see some edge distortion dependent on the type of glass that's been used and the type of manufacturing process. With an achromat lens, there's two elements bonded together to reduce those edge distortions and reduce some of the chromatic aberrations or color fringes that you sometimes see using the single element lens. The Raynox lenses go a little bit further. They've got 2 or 3 elements in there to give you more correction and more color correction. Again, you get strengths of 150 and 250, which equate to a number 3 or a number 4 diopter lens. Talking about macro zoom works by setting first of all the camera to its widest angle setting of 25 millimeters. And then to achieve the image magnification, it uses digital zoom. So we are going to see some image degradation, particularly in stills mode. If you're shooting video, then the image resolution isn't quite as high as stills mode. So you can probably get away with some of the higher magnifications in macro zoom if you're shooting video. If you've got the camera set to, say, a 9 megapixel image, which then is scaled down to give you a JPEG, if you have, say, a 3 megapixel image by the compression, when you go to times 2 digital zoom or times 2 zoom, 50 millimeters effective focal length on these cameras, you'll still get that 3 megapixel image because it scales up the image by interpolation. So you'll always get the same file size, you just get a larger magnification of your image. In some circumstances, the image quality might be acceptable for your use. Depends again on the subject and the amount of resolution you need for your final publication. I found that if you want the best image quality, you are still better using close-up lenses than using macro zoom. It's a fail-safe mode if you've got no lenses with you and you need to get a larger image at the widest angle setting. Then use macro zoom to give you that slight enlargement. Bear in mind, if you go to times 3, you will see image degradation. Now, there are some caveats when considering using the AF macro zoom with the FZ300, 1000 or the 2000. It's a digital process, so you can't apply it to raw images. It's a JPEG only magnification. So if you've got your camera set to raw, you'll find that you can't use the AF macro zoom mode. Also, to get into the AF macro mode, you can't be in manual focus. It's an AF operation, so you do need to be in one of the autofocus modes, either AFS, AFF, or AFC, to allow you to use the AF macro mode. Now let's look at that in a real world situation. I've used the FZ300 with the AF macro mode and the macro zoom mode in both stills and video to show you the image quality with the AF macro mode, the macro zoom mode, and with a combination of close-up lenses. And you can see the type of image quality we get by using these lenses compared to macro zoom mode. So I've set the camera up to around about 6 inches or 15 centimeters away from the subject, so you can see the angle of view, the amount of depth of field. I'll be shooting at f5.6. So you can see the amount of depth of field you'll get by using the combination of a close-up lens or the macro zoom. Now applying macro zoom in video, 4K video, going from 36mm to 108. Well, that's it for this video. Thanks very much for watching. I hope you did find the information useful. Of course, if you're a new viewer to the channel, please do click that subscribe button. It really does help when you do that. Also, take a look at my photographic blog if you've not seen that before. I'll put a link to it in the video description below. Now, on that blog, there's lots more information about Panasonic Lumix bridge cameras, Micro Four Thirds systems, and some of the Canon systems. There's also on the homepage an invitation to join my 3-weekly newsletter, and that newsletter contains a lot more technical information than I publish on the actual blog itself. So it's a way of saying thank you for your subscription to that newsletter. There's also some download section there with some free to download hints and tips for bridge cameras and some of the sections from my manuals for the FZ200 and the FZ300-330. So that's it for this video. Thanks very much for watching. Please do take care, and I'll see you all in the next one. Goodbye for now.